So what is up guys, it's the boy who unboxes phones at 12 AM over here. Like, I don't know whether it's funny or not, or I should go to bed, because literally it's the time right now which is printed on the box, 12:23, and I am unboxing this phone. Because when I went to the store, I wonder what it is, because literally I wanted a J7 Pro for the longest time. Already had the J7 Max, I made a review of it. If you want to check that, just tap over here. And I just saw that there's new red box. So today all of the boxes are in yellow or white nowadays, or even blue, and the S series in the black. Because most of the time, almost for the Samsung, we always hear news from every where that Samsung is actually updating its phone. Mostly while updating, Samsung doesn't tell anyone, it just updates its lineup. But releasing a whole new entire phone, and especially J7, you can get a J7 in 11,000 rupees now, which is like, wow, our whole life is a lie. Earlier it was like you should have 15 to 16,000 as a budget or over that in order to buy a J7. J7 Pro is for 21, J7 Max is for 18,000, J7 2016 is like around 12,000 by now, and this phone specific you can now buy it for 11,500. And I seriously don't know anything about this, so let's just check it out by unboxing it. So yeah, huge thanks to Tarang Mobile Collection. If you live in Alibag City, please check out their store. And let's just take a look at the handset, because literally I have not heard anything. There is one YouTuber here has already uploaded some benchmarks and comparisons, but I'm just listening about this phone right now, like 1 hour ago. Construction is pure plastic, so I would not even compare it to the Redmi Note 3, but the phone is huge. I know it's a 5.5-inch display, but as you can see, in my left hand, there is a Redmi Note 3. It's surprisingly light, like look at that. So let's just take a look at the contents in the box. There are some manuals. There is a charger, 5 watts at 155 amps. Pretty fast. It's not fast as a Galaxy SMS charger. That's like 5 watts at 2 amps. In other contents, you get earbuds, which are again just the plastic ones. You don't get anything fancy with these things. That's a standard USB you are getting. But I do have to say they have upgraded the quality on the USB. And here's the battery. It's quite huge for a 3000 mAh. Again, no comparisons to the Redmi Note 3. I don't want to hurt Xiaomi fans at all. They just peel off the plastic carefully. There's a screen protector on the front, which is weird. I have never seen a Samsung phone without a screen protector. And usually these J7s come with like a midnight finish, but this phone is purely black and I'm quite liking it. But the internals are completely black, like they have blacked out everything. Things we have to do. Let's just begin with the setup. Next, terms and conditions, agree to all. You should get a screen protector. The screen is extremely oleophobic. Wow, the screen color accuracy is amazing. Let's just go to the Android settings. Apps open fairly quick. About device, software info, July security patch, amazing. Android 7.0. So yeah, you are not getting anything fancier than that, because literally my Galaxy S8 is running Android 7.0. There is all the Samsung bloaters, such as you can see, FM radio. It's 2017. You get the game tools and the game launcher, both of them. I guess on all of the Nougat phones, it's just standard stuff. And that's pretty much it, guys. Thanks for watching. If you want a full review of this phone, please subscribe down there and let me know if you want to see a comparison between this device and the Redmi Note 3. So guys, yeah, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Peace.